very warm welcome to the Minister of Democratic Institution, the Honourable Maryam Monsef.
Hello, Waterloo Region. You look so good right now. Bonjour, Ani, Salam. Special shout out to the Afghan Canadians who are in the room. If you drove in, we saw you all walk in together, and I may have gotten a little excited and said, those are some of my people, and it turned out that you were, and what a great privilege it is to be here with some of the people who keep me motivated and inspired in the House of Commons. We, earlier today, were at the University of Toronto, where we met with a group of young women and talked about the importance of engaging women in the democratic process, not just as voters, but as candidates as well. And we talked about how it's one thing to encourage her to run, you gotta ask her a lot. It's another thing to help her win her seat, and then it's a whole other thing to help her succeed once she gets there. I'm from Peterborough, Wartha, where my community has been my source of inspiration and motivation. And the great privilege it is to serve them is also a bit of a paradox because I find myself far away from them. And with that void, there are some challenges. But very quickly I learned that it is my colleagues in Ottawa who have become my community. It is my colleagues who help me on those days where things aren't going the way I want them to. It's my colleagues who inspire me to continue this very important work that we're doing together on behalf of all of you, because we are experiencing a rare window of opportunity with democratic renewal. Where in the world do citizens have an opportunity to have a say in how they're governed? Where in the world do citizens have an opportunity to constructively criticize their government without fear of persecution? Where in the world can somebody like me come to this country and 20 years later be able to put her name on a ballot and actually win? Our democratic institutions have served us well, and they're not completely broken. But we have an opportunity right now, when there's no major crisis, there's relative peace and stability, to take a hard look at these gifts that have been passed down to us for nearly 150 years and see what we can do to strengthen them for our children and grandchildren. Now, the conversation you're going to be having with us tonight is part of the conversation that's happening across the country. MPs like yours here tonight are creating a platform for their constituents to be heard in this process. There's a special committee devoted to this work. They spent their summer in electoral reform boot camp, and they're about to get out there and hit every province and territory with a message of, what do you want your electoral system to do for you? We've also opened up online channels, so if you go on canada.ca/democracy, you'll find more than you need to inform yourselves, your communities, and your colleagues, even host your own town hall. And of course, I've been connecting with Canadians across the country to hear from them. Now, what's going to happen with these conversations? Your MPs will submit them to the committee. And come December 1st, they will provide us with a report on their recommendations on an alternate way of voting, mandatory voting, online voting, and how to determine whether any reform has the broad support of Canadians. That report, along with the feedback I'm receiving from Canadians, will form the basis of legislation that we intend to introduce in the House of Commons in the spring of this coming year. I'm sure there will be a lively debate in the House of Commons when that legislation is introduced, and then there will be a vote. It will then go to the Senate, where I have a feeling there will be an impassioned debate about it there and a vote. And what we hope at the end of this process Knowing that there will be no consensus on this very exciting issue, what we hope is that at the end of this process, you're able to see yourselves in the outcome. You're able to hear your voices in the outcome. Now, whose land am I on tonight? Shabbat? Whose land am I on?
First Nations.
Which ones? We are on Algonquin territory?
Native land.
We are on Algonquin native land? Is that what it is? Well, it's a great privilege to be on this traditional territory. And with this privilege comes a great deal of responsibility. I'm proud to be part of a government that is willing to do right by our responsibilities and commitments. How many of you in this room have already made up your mind about which electoral system we should go with? Raise your hands. Okay. Voting is mandatory for this, by the way. Raise your hands again. And look around, please. Take a look around. How many of you in this room have made up your mind about which electoral system to go with? How many of you are here because you're curious and you've yet to make up your mind? Okay. How many of you think we should go with mandatory voting? Raise your hands. Take a look around. This is one that gets people super excited. How many of you don't think we should have mandatory voting? How many of you think this is a silly question and I should just not be asking it? How many of you are abstaining because you don't know enough about it to make an informed opinion just yet? Okay, now I will say, the only way I was able to understand what you folks in this room thought about mandatory voting is because voting for this was mandatory. Just say. How many of you in this room think that you should be able to walk into a polling station and instead of using a pencil and a piece of paper, you should push a button and cast your vote that way? Electronic voting. How many of you think that's a bad idea? Raise your hands. Most of you. Okay, how many of you don't know enough yet? Some of you. How many of you think you should be able to vote for your candidates on your telephone? Or from your computer, online voting. How many proponents of online voting in this room? How many think don't do it? Okay, and how many don't know enough yet? Okay. Okay, this is, so two things. This is what we want you to talk about tonight. And I want you to know that we're not making any decisions tonight. We're simply adding this to the rich range of conversations that we are and have been hearing from Canadians. The reason I wanted to do a straw poll, it's not binding, so don't worry, you can change your minds. It is okay. The reason I wanted you to see each other's hands is because there is no consensus. But the ultimate outcome, we have to be prepared to recognize that we're not after perfection. The search for perfect will be paralyzing. We are looking for the best possible outcome. And we're looking for the kind of outcome that is based on a set of principles that we cherish in our democratic institutions. We want an effective and legitimate system with integrity. We want one that's accessible and inclusive. We want one that encourages collaboration and enhances diversity. At the end of the day, if we do our job right, and we're able to find common ground, I believe this country will be best served. And my goal is that more people will vote, but also more people will start putting their names on that ballot, so that more people who don't usually vote start seeing people who look and sound like them in that place, and get excited about politics. And ultimately, when a few years from now, other democratic nations decide to reform their institutions, they will look at Canada and say, there's a good example of how to do it right. So I thank you for making time to be here. Be mindful of who is not in this room and do your best to advocate for them and to talk about this outside this room. If you're here, you are what millennials affectionately call democracy geeks. Be proud of that. and spread the word for us. I hope you have a great time tonight, and I look forward to the conversation. Thank you.